We got a whiteboard video for you today, but first thing you got to do is screenshot this shit because we're going to erase it later, but we want to reference it. So go ahead, get a screenshot. Good, you got it. Cool. Let's start the video. In today's whiteboard video, we're talking about how to set your macros once you've established what your calorie intake should be for the day. Now, it probably makes sense to do a video on how to find what your calorie intake should be for the day, but you could just go on Google and type in calorie calculator and you'll find tons of different ways to find that, and they're all estimates. So you're never going to get an exact number, and that's why we're not going to do a whole video on it right now. But pretty much they're going to ask you for your age, your height, your weight, your body fat percentage, your activity level. They're going to give you a number, which is your maintenance calories, and tell you if you want to lose fat, lower that number. If you want to gain muscle, increase that number. And again, maintenance is not static, so it's never the same every single day, and it changes based on your activity level, your training intensity, different variables and factors. So if you want to see a separate video on that, just let me know. I'd be more than happy to do it. But we're talking about how to break down your macros and what your individual protein, carbs, and fats should be once you've established what your total calorie intake should be for the day. So this table is not something I made up. It's actually taken from the Muscle and Strength Pyramid, the Nutrition Edition by my man Eric Helms. So you know the information's good. So we're gonna talk about protein, fats, and carbs, whether you're in a cutting phase or a gaining phase, and then give some examples later on. First things first, no matter whether you're cutting or bulking, you usually set your protein intake. That's the first thing you set, and we're going to go with 1.1 to 1.3 grams per pound of body weight per day if you are in a cutting phase. Some people might think that's high. A lot of people are used to the 1 gram per pound of body weight, so if you're 200 pounds, 200 grams for protein a day, keep it simple that way. That's fine. The reason why the numbers are a bit higher here is because when you're in a deficit, you're trying to preserve as much lean body mass as possible. So keeping that protein a little bit higher can help you do that. It also helps with satiation and appetite. So you're a bit more satisfied, a bit more full, trying to get rid of some cravings. For some people, they don't like their protein very high, but I would say sticking to the lowest end of that and not going lower than that could be a pretty good idea. So then you have that set up right there. I also have it in kilograms, so 2.3 to 2.8 grams per kilogram of body weight. Once you set your protein intake, the next thing you're going to set is your fat intake. And then we fill the rest with carbs because carbs are actually a non-essential macronutrient. So you don't actually need carbohydrates. We all like them, they taste good, they help with our energy levels, they help with performance, but they're not actually essential. So that's why we set them last. So we got our protein set, now we're going over to our fats. Typically 15 to 25% of your total calorie intake for the day. That number is based on the individual and their individual preferences. Some people can get away with lower fat. They function fine. Fat helps with your brain. So a lot of people struggle when they actually bring their fat too low. Cognitive function slows down a bit. They find it harder to focus. And they notice when they increase their fats, they actually feel a lot better. So that number is just a ballpark range. Some people go to 30% of their total calories, but I wouldn't suggest taking the fats too low because they are essential for hormone function. So keeping fat between 15 and 25 is a good range, and that number will depend on your individual preference. And then, like I said, you fill the rest with carbohydrates. Now, not too much changes when you jump into a gaining phase. You actually will notice a lower protein intake at 0.8 to 1 gram per pound of body weight per day. So you're probably thinking, you know, a lot of people, we think protein, we think building muscle. So why is it that if your goal is to gain and build muscle that your protein intake would be lower? The reason for that is simply because you're in a calorie surplus. You're providing your body with much more energy through calorie intake. So there's not so much of a worry about preserving as much lean mass because you're in a surplus. So you're giving your body more than it actually needs just to maintain. So keeping the protein a little bit lower will allow you to bump up the fats and carbs a little bit more. So 0.8 to 1 gram or 1.8 to 2.3 grams per kilogram of body weight per day. Next up, we set the fat intake, about 20 to 30% of your total calories. You'll notice that number isn't that much higher than when you're cutting. And the reason for that is because we don't want the fat intake to get out of control either. We are in a surplus, fats are essential, but they'll be higher just given the fact that we are in a surplus. Then we jump into the carbs and we fill the remaining calories with carbs. Now, what are our total calories for the day? We're gonna go over two quick examples, one for cutting, one for bulking. So like I said, I'm gonna erase this shit. Hopefully you took a screenshot. I'll give you another chance. All right, chance is over. So now we're gonna erase this and talk about the examples. And we're back, and there's a lot more shit on here now, so I hope you took that screenshot earlier, open it up, keep it to the side just in case you want to reference it. But ignore that side of the board because we're going to do one example at a time, starting with your cutting phase. Just a quick recap, beginner stuff, protein is 4 calories per gram, fat is 9 calories per gram, carbs are 4 calories per gram. Just some background information to help you understand this a little bit better. So we're in our cutting phase. We typed in our stats on the calorie calculator online. They told us that in order to be in a deficit, we need to consume 2,500 calories per day. So we're a 200 pound person. Our calorie intake is 2,500 calories. Now we break that down into macronutrients based on the chart we talked about earlier. So we're gonna set protein intake first. We're gonna go towards the lower end so we don't scare people away with tons of protein. So it was anywhere from 1.1 to 1.3 grams per pound. The lower end is 1.1. So we take 1.1 times our body weight, which is 200, and we get 220 grams of protein per day. You multiply that by 4, and that's 880 calories. Protein intake is set. Next, we move on to our fat intake. So we're gonna go towards right in the middle. So we're going with 20% of our total calories. So we take 20% of 2,500 calories, and we get 500. Now with that 500, we divide it by 9 calories per gram, we end up with 55.6 grams of fat. So we have our fat intake per day at 55, our protein intake per day at 220. Now we just fill the rest up with carbs. So how do we do that? We take 880, which is our calories from protein, we take 500, which is our calories from fat, and we add those together. We end up getting 1,380 calories. That makes up protein and fat. Now we come back to this number, 2,500. Do 2,500 minus the 1,380, and we get 1,120. We divide that by 4 for carbs, and we end up with 280 grams of carbs per day. I hope that wasn't confusing. It might sound easier in my head than it actually looks, but that's as simple as we're doing. We're setting protein, we're setting fat, and we're filling the rest with carbs. So for someone who's 200 pounds, eating 2,500 calories per day, and that's their deficit, their breakdown can look something like this. 220 grams of protein per day, 55 grams of fat per day, and 280 grams of carbs per day. And remember, these are estimates, these are ranges, and these are based on individual preferences. So you might find someone who thinks that's a little low for them. They want to go up to 240 grams of protein per day. Or maybe they want to actually drop it down to 200 grams per day. I work with my clients, and we have different numbers for every single person based on what they like. So fat, you might want to go up to 65, 70 grams per day. You might drop it down a little bit. Carbs, you mess around with. So these numbers are not set in stone. These are based on ranges. Now we move on to gaining. The same exact rules apply. So we have someone who's gaining. They did the calculator thing. They are 200 pounds, just to keep things simple. And their gaining phase is 3,000 calories per day. That is their surplus. So we break it down the same way. We're gonna go on the lower end of protein because like I mentioned earlier, you're getting extra calories so you don't need as much protein as when you're cutting. So we'll keep it simple, 1 gram per pound. So it's 200 pounds, 200 grams of protein, done. Next, we're gonna set the fat. We're gonna go right in the middle of the range at around 25% of your total calories. So 25% of 3,000 calories, we're gonna get 750. Divide that by 9 to find out how many grams of fat we need. Come out to about 83.3. And obviously we're gonna round that number 80, 85, but just for math purposes, we're gonna keep it there. We set our protein, we set our fats, we add those together, 800 calories from protein, 750 calories from fat. We get 1,550, take 3,000, subtract the protein and fat calories, which is 1,550, we get 1,450. We divide that by 4, and the remainder is our carbs at 362 grams. So someone who's in a gaining phase or bulking at 3,000 calories, their breakdown might look like this. 200 grams of protein per day, 83 grams of fat per day, 362 grams of carbs. And again, those numbers can change. You can go up to 400 grams of carbs and bring the fats down a little bit. You can bump the protein up a little bit and bring the carbs down a little bit. So don't let anyone tell you these have to be your macros based on this calculator, or you need to eat this much fat, protein, and carbs in order to reach your goals. individual preference. You do what you like, but sticking to somewhere around these ranges is generally a good idea. So I do hope this video helped some of you guys out. Hopefully it was easy enough to understand. If you want to see a video more about setting your actual calorie intake for the day, like we talked about earlier, we could do that. Just let me know in the comment section below. If you did enjoy this style of video, do me a favor, hit that thumbs up button. That really helps me out. I appreciate the support as always, guys. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll talk to you in the next video. Testing, testing. I fucked up. It will give you a number and say, fucking, was that good? My life be like.